On the other side of the political aisle, a DFL state senator representing Blaine and Coon Rapids announced he will not file for re-election in 2022.
The big thing is I will be 85 next year. And already I'm the oldest person that has ever served in the Senate. I still feel capable. I still feel, good about what I'm doing. I enjoy what I'm doing. But there comes a time.
Jerry Newton says it's about spending more time with family. He will finish out his term as senator, a position he's held since 2017. Before that, he served in the State House, on the school board, and as a Coon Rapids City Council member, where he helped create a national standard to silence train horns at crossings. All of this as a DFLer in what he says is a district that's primarily Republican.
I've been around for so long and people know my name. That name recognition is terribly important in Coon Rapids, but also in Blaine. I owned a grocery store there for some 20 years, and I was there 7 days a week, every day of the year for 20 years. And really got to know the families and grew up, with their kids and things like that.
In the legislature, Newton is most proud of building a new 100-bed facility for veterans at the Minneapolis Veterans Home and setting up a veterans court to help with issues related to PTSD and substance abuse.
Its veterans are given a mentor to help them get through issues, and they end up without having a big court record that's going to preclude them from getting jobs, finding housing, and things like that. And it's been extremely successful.
He hopes to get funding to help restore parts of the National Sports Center in the next legislative session. He serves on the Amateur Sports Commission. But after a political career spanning 27 years, Jerry Newton says it's time to move on.
There comes a time when you pass the baton on to younger people and help guide them in the first year or so that they're in there and just keep on keeping on.
Jerry Newton said a current Coon Rapids City Council member has announced she has an interest in running for the office.